In this video, I'll talk about white noise. Now, white noise is a signal wherein the mean is zero. The variance of the signal is a constant and is independent of time. And the autocorrelation of the time series with any of the lag versions of the time series is zero. So there is no significant autocorrelation between your time series, that is your white noise time series, and any of its lag version. Why is it important? When you build a linear regression model or a time series model, you can evaluate if your residuals are white noise or not. Why is it important? One of the assumptions of linear regression is that your errors are kind of independent in nature. Now, if you can use a test to detect if your residuals are white noise or not, then you can infer that your linear regression model is well fit. Same holds true for a time series data as well. So in this video, we look at a test called as Ljung-Box test and not a Ljung-Box test to detect if your time series is white noise or not. So I hope you all like it. Let's start by importing the necessary modules. As we all know by now what the theory of white noise is, let's create some white noise by adding some random numbers of length 100 and checking the autocorrelation plot. As you can clearly see, I've created a completely random series of 100 points and I'm checking for lag values till 20 if there is any significant autocorrelation of my time series with a lagged version of the time series. From the graph, it is evident that there is no such autocorrelation that exists between my actual time series and, say, for example, time series at lag 1, time series at lag 2, and so on and so forth. Rather than having to visually look at the autocorrelation plot in order to infer if we have white noise or not, there is something called as the Ljung-Box test, which kind of helps you infer if your time series is white noise or not. So for every test, we basically define something called as a null hypothesis and an alternate hypothesis. The null hypothesis in case of a white noise series or in case of Ljung-Box statistics is that there is no autocorrelation between the signal and the lagged version of that signal. The alternate hypothesis is that there is significant autocorrelation between the signal and the lagged version of the signal. So if I have to infer that a given time series is white noise or not, then I'll accept the null hypothesis and reject the alternate hypothesis. If I have to infer that a given series is not white noise, then I'll have to reject the null hypothesis and accept the alternate hypothesis. The formula that is used to calculate the critical value of this test is n into n plus 2, where n is the number of samples that I've considered. Rk cap, the whole square, is basically the autocorrelation of your actual time series with the kth value of the time series, where k starts from 1. The reason why this test starts from 1 is any random time series, if it is checked with itself, would be heavily correlated, or it will have a value of 1 as correlation. So we don't want that to create an impact on our test. So we start our k from 1. And I also divide the value by n minus k, where n is the total number of samples that I have and k is the lag value that I'm checking for the autocorrelation. Whatever critical value I get is compared against a chi-square distribution table with h degrees of freedom, where h is calculated using the ARMA or ARIMA models p and q orders, and it is also tested against a significance level of alpha. Now that we know what the test is, let's run this test for 20 lags for our given 100 data points and see what we observe. This is the table that I've derived from the Ljung-Box test. I am checking at a confidence interval of 90%, and if you look at the Q value and compare it with the critical value, at no instant is the Q value greater than the critical value. That means I'll accept my null hypothesis and reject my alternate hypothesis. To simply put, I infer from this test that the given time series is a white noise time series. What if we do this on an actual time series where there is some amount of autocorrelation? Let's see how the test performs in that case. So I load a simple data set. And when I find the autocorrelation function or the autocorrelation plot of that time series, this is what I get. There is a heavy correlation or autocorrelation of the time series and the time series shifted by one unit, that is at lag 1. Similarly, this autocorrelation is very high for almost all the lags that I've considered in our given example. When I run the same lunchbox test again for the new time series that I haven't had, this is what I observe. At every step, my Q value, that is this value that I've computed, is greater than my critical value of my chi-square table at a particular degree of freedom and a confidence interval of 90%. So that means when Q is greater than my critical value, I reject my null hypothesis and I accept my alternate hypothesis. In our case, our alternate hypothesis is that there is a heavy autocorrelation between the time series and the lagged version of the time series. So this was my take on how you can use lunchbox test effectively to find out if a given time series or if a given residual plot is white noise or not. If you do have any questions with what we've covered in this video, then feel free to ask in the comment section below and I'll do my best to answer those. If you enjoy these tutorials and would like to support them, then the easiest way is to simply like the video and give it a thumbs up. And also, it's a huge help to share these videos with anyone whom you think would find them useful. Please consider clicking the subscribe button to be notified for future videos. And thank you so much for watching the video.